I watched from behind a tree as Bernice Benedict slipped out of their cabin. She was wearing a dark halter top and dark slacks that almost blended with her burnt black skin, making a wraith of her. She had a big white handbag on a shoulder strap. She was so dark, the white bag seemed to float in space as she headed toward the lodge. Only she stopped and found her own tree to duck behind. I smiled to myself. Then, wearing the pale blue polyester sport coat, I entered their cabin through the door she'd left open. The room was completely dark, but for some minor filtering in of light through curtained windows. Quickly, I arranged some pillows under sheets and covers to create the impression of a person in the bed, and I called Adam's cabin. "Hey, Bill," I said, "it's Jim." His voice was breathless. "Is it done?" "No, I got cornered coming out of the bar by that waitress I was out with last night. She latched onto me. She's in my john." "What? Are you in your room?" "Yeah, I saw Benedict leave the bar at midnight and his wife passed us, heading for the lodge just minutes ago. You've got a clear shot at him." "What, me? I'm the fucking lookout." "Tonight's the night, and we go to Plan C." "I didn't know there was a Plan C. Listen, asshole, it was you who wanted to switch plans. You've got a piece, don't you?" "Of course." "Well, you're elected. Go." And I hung up. I stood in the doorway of the bathroom, which faced the bed. I sure as hell didn't turn any lights on, though my left hand hovered by the switch. The 9mm with the silencer was heavy in my right hand, but I didn't mind. Adam came in quickly and didn't do too bad a job of it. 4 silent slugs. He should have checked the body. It never occurred to him he just slaughtered a bunch of pillows, but if somebody had been in that bed, they'd have been dead. He went to the dresser where he knew the jewels would be and was picking up the jewelry box when the door opened and she came in, the little revolver already in her hand. Before she could fire, I turned on the bathroom light and said, "If I don't hear the gun hit the floor immediately, you're fucking dead." She was just a black shape, except for the white handbag. But I saw the flash of silver as the gun bounced to the carpeted floor. "What?" Adam was saying. It was too dark to see any expression, but he was obviously as confused as he was spooked. "Shut the door, lady," I said, "and turn on the lights." She did. She really was a beautiful woman, or had been. Dark eyes and scarlet-painted mouth and that finely carved model's face, but it was just a leathery mask to me. "What?" Adam said. He looked shocked as hell, which made sense. The gun was in his waistband, the jewelry box in his hands. "You didn't know there were 2 of us, did you, Mrs. Benedict?" She was sneering faintly. She shook her head. "No." "You see, kid," I told Adam, "she wanted her husband hit, but she wanted the hitman dead, too. Cleaner, tidier, right?" "Fuck you," she said. "I'm not much for sloppy seconds, thanks. Bet you got a nice legal license for that little purse pea shooter of yours, don't you? Perfect protection for when you stumble in on an intruder who's just killed your loving husband, who is dead, by the way. Somebody'll run across him in the morning, probably." "You bitch," Adam said. He raised his own gun, which was a .380 Browning with a homemade suppressor. "Don't you know it's bad luck to kill a woman?" I said. She was frozen, one eye twitching. Adam was trembling. He swallowed, nodded. "Okay," he said, lowering the gun. Okay. "Go," I told him. She stepped aside as he slipped out the door, shutting it behind him. "Thank you," she said, and I shot her twice in the chest. I slipped the bulky silenced automatic in my waistband, grabbed the jewel box off the dresser. "I make my own luck," I told her, but she didn't hear me as I stepped over her. I never worked with Adam again. I think he was disturbed when he read the papers and realized I'd iced the woman after all. Maybe he got out of the business, or maybe he wound up dead in a ditch, his lucky skull ring still on his little finger. Broker never said, and I was never interested enough to ask. Now, years later, lounging in the hot tub at Sylvan Lodge, I look back on my actions and wonder how I could have ever been so young and so rash. Killing the woman was understandable. She double-crossed us. She would have killed us both without batting a false lash. But sleeping with that cowgirl waitress on the job, smoking dope, not using a rubber, I was really pushing my luck that time.